bell, brand new shoes, walking blues, climb the fence, books and pens.
Well, here we are, boys and girls, another beautiful day up at Crestview Mountain Resort. The only thing really missing out of me and Matt's morning this morning was a good old box of Tim Horton donuts, but, you know, we made it off okay and we're up here right now having fun. I'm just going to lay down some basic principles about snowboarding. This here eating device, or snowboard, whatever you want to call it. These are your binders, which your feet go in through here, and you just put them in there, and then you like strap them shut like this, you know, just, they click and whatnot. This is a high back. This is so you can really turn on your heels well and you don't break the hell out of your ankles when you're snowboarding. As far as your basics, you got your toe side edge here, where your toes are. So it's called a toe side edge. And you got your heel side here, where your heels are. And these are basically your two means of making your way around the mountain, so to speak. But basically, snowboarding comes down to these two edges and how you use them on the mountain and how you feel them underneath your feet. I mean, basically, you gotta be able to realize the pitch of the mountain, judge how fast you're going, and from there forward, you determine how much pressure you should have on each edge. Oh, hey there again, we're back. So as I was saying before, left foot forward is regular, right foot forward is goofy, and it's also called switch riding when you're riding with your opposite foot, but those two edges play a big role in how you ride on the mountain. And basically a lot of people, common misconception about snowboarding, let me go ahead and lay this out for people who don't know. You really can't ride on the complete bottom part of your board. You always want to be on some sort of an edge. If you're just riding on the bottom part of your board, you're going to get squirrely, you're going to catch a snow, you're going to catch an edge, and you're not going to have a good day. It's not going to be a good day. So now I'm going to talk a little bit about the hearsay basics and dynamics of how you actually go down the mountain on one of these here devices. But basically, your back foot plays pretty much your major role and how you turn and whatnot. Your front foot's there, it's just kind of a guiding factor, and make sure that you're going straight, you know, because going straight is good. I mean, you can go back and forth across the run, but generally you just want to go fast, real fast, straight. That's what we snowboarders like to do, is go real fast, straight. So back foot control, I mean, mainly when you're riding, you're going to be towards your back foot like this, and that's where the toes and the heels come from. It's all about weight transitioning. The heel side is much harder to learn and be effective at, because if you look at the dynamics of a snowboard and how your weight's centered, when you're up on your toes, it's really hard to, I mean, you can basically get all your weight over your toes, so your toe side edge is always going to be a lot stronger than your heel side edge. Heels, you really can't, it's kind of hard to, in order for you to center your weight, you have to be leaning backwards, and you know, that's just not going to work. So back foot control comes into everything. Your transitioning, you really just, it's all about using your back foot. You control and sweep with your back foot.
My name is Spencer, I'm 8, and I've been snowboarding for 1 year, and I love it a lot.
He loves it a lot. Do you like skiing or snowboarding better?
Snowboarding.
Snowboarding, yeah. That's what I like to hear. All right, so we'll just get some shots of you going down here. Just make some turns for us, bud. Go back and forth and show us how it's done, all right? Traversing the slope on his heels here. Now he's going to his toes. Notice how he sweeps that back foot back and forth there. Killing it. Doing good. And he's going to take a little run for us here. Now those toes there. Having trouble transitioning to the heels. Sweeps that back foot out. Oh, almost had the heels. Notice how beginners really having trouble. On one edge, you'd be scared. Back and forth. You're not waiting right here. See, she's grinding on her toes, just feeling out.
Now he's coming back with his toes, heels, toes. You know, he's pretty well practiced, I'd say myself. Here he comes. His buddy's also very good. Oh, now he's getting a little spin going. That's pretty cool there, huh? There he goes right there. And basically, he stops. Here's another good right here. You're on film, buddy! All right. Get some more people coming up. Here's another guy right here. Look at that guy right there going on a snowboard. Oh.
This, the falling leaf is what I'm talking about right here. See, oh, yeah, we got that on film. That's the recipe for a bad day right there. This guy's a little more advanced. He's going fast. Look at that. Oh, man, he knows he's on film. He's excited. Got another, probably another novice there. I'm just going to start giving people ratings right now, just when they're coming down the hill. Hold up. The lens is a little dirty there. Let me wipe that off there. All right. Waiting for some more snowboarders to funnel down here. Oh, there's another snowboarder right there. Oh, he's got his jacket open. He must be good. Oh, look at that. Carving in.
Look at me. I'm skiing. I'm skiing, dude.
What up,
my
Alex?
My first time skiing ever.
Dude, we're actually filming a documentary on snowboarding right now. No, it's fine. You can be in it. We're taking some shots of some novice. Oh, novice snowboarder right there. Novice.
My first time skiing ever, dude.
It's probably like a four. I'm going to give him a four or a five.
It's just pretty fun.
But, yeah.
Get on with it. I'll catch you guys later.
Get in. I'm going out. Let's get this. This is the last guy we're going to film right here. Really watch him use his heels right there. Toes. Notice how he sweeps that back foot out. That back foot is like a pivoting that you control back behind you. Your front foot really does nothing but to steady you. So we're gonna go ahead and cut it out here. Some good shots.
I can tell that we are gonna be friends. I can tell that we are gonna be friends. Walk with me, Susie Lee, through the park and by the tree. We'll rest upon the ground and look at all the bugs we found. Safely walk to school without a sound. Safely walk to school without a sound. Here we are, no one else. We walk to school all by ourselves. There's
no stairway.
Oh, sorry, I caught up so much in the power of Zeppelin there. Welcome to Snow Chat. This is Panzer. He fancies himself a snowboard. This is Travis again, and we got Mike over here. He's going to do, I guess, a little bit of talking. I don't even know. Who cares? He's a skier. Nobody cares.
Yeah, my name's Mike Hughes, semi-professional skier and amateur veterinarian. So, Travis, what do you call a snowboarder without a girlfriend?
What?
Homeless!
Oh, come on, man.
What's the difference between a beginning snowboarder and a snowboard instructor?
What's that?
3 days!
Sick burn.
How many snowboarders does it take to screw in a light bulb?
I don't know.
None! They're too damn stoned to figure it out!